Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we tried to create this kind of structure, okay, where we had an Nginx and Nginx was doing internal routing through the UI applications and different microservices. Here you can have an API gateway also, like not AWS API gateway, your simple Node.js service which is acting as an API gateway. And if you talk in terms of AWS, AWS also works in the same way. Here you have a Route 53 and Route 53 is serving your front end through some domain, through a cloud front end S3 bucket, and then it is talking to some kind of a load balancer. Load balancer is routing the traffic to these either EC2 instance or ECS cluster. Okay, coming back to microservice development, here we will try to baseline our simple service. So let's say if we create a new auth service, it can be auth microservice we are going to build, okay? And how it is going to be, we are going to create a TypeScript based structure here. So we'll go to auth, and first of all we'll do npm init. We got the package.json in the auth, and we'll start adding the required things for our package. So what all things we need, we are going to use express with the TypeScript. So we need a tsconfig, tslint. We will also have a Docker file, same as this user service, where we have a Docker file. Same kind of a Docker file we will put in our auth service, okay? And Docker ignore file, package.json, orm-config, nodemon.json. So let's create these one by one. Either you can bootstrap the whole project using some CLI, or you can create. And so in package.json, first of all, what we will do, we will import all required packages, okay? So we are going to use TypeScript with Express. So all the required packages, what all packages we are going to have is Express, and we are going to use TypeORM for database connections, MySQL. So we will include all those packages. So first of all, npm install --- save Express. These are dependencies. Express, we can have body parser. Body parser express, express Winston. So all these packages we will keep adding. We will add Helmet, all the other packages like JSON Web Token and all, because we are going to. So you have to create a base template. In base template, you don't need additional packages like JSON Web Token or any other libraries. Okay, here we can add a TypeScript. And Winston is another package. We'll be using MySQL 2 because in base package, baseline, or you can say a basic starter application for microservice, you can at least add MySQL 2, considering that you are going to work with RDS, okay, or Mongoose for MongoDB, okay, .env, because that is required for managing the environments. And similarly, we will just populate our package.json. And if for any external calls, we can use Exios library. So we'll just add that. Exios, nodemon, okay. And we are going to use TypeORM as a ORM solution to deal with MySQL database, okay. Helmet, which is used for security. Okay, what else we have? At least and body parser, we already have. Bluebird, bcrypt, Exios, all these libraries are fine, okay? So we'll just start with the very basic dependencies, and we also need to add a dev dependencies, which are types node, types express, all these. So --- save --dev, we will add that as a dev dependency. Okay, so for dev dependency, we have to add fuse dependencies, which is types node, types express. Okay, types express, and we also have other libraries, chai, mocha, all the other testing libraries, like you have chai, okay, mocha, tsnode, tsnode-dev, okay, tsnode, tsnode-dev, nyc for getting the code coverage, Knock, which is a mocking library, okay. Istanbul, which is also helper library for code coverage. Chai HTTP, Chai as promise, okay. Types node, types validator, these are libraries. We keep adding these libraries because these are required, and we are adding them as a dev dependency for our package.json. I mean, if you just go ahead and go to the GitHub, you will get a starter application. You don't need to struggle in doing a baseline of your simple application, okay? So what I will do is I will add my own dev dependencies. You also have a TSLint and all. So in my starter project, I have these many dependencies. I will be adding them, okay? And I will be doing npm install. So I just need, it will refresh my package log JSON. We will not need AJV. So we'll just filter it out what all dependencies we need. I just copied it from the base package. We don't need this. We don't need Bluebird library initially. Class validator, k.env we need. Inversify for dependency injection we will have. Lodash we can remove. MySQL to nodemon sleep, okay. That is fine. So what we will do is I will remove the package log JSON and remove node modules so I can have a fresh dependencies or node modules folder. Now I will do npm install. It will take some time, but my dependencies are now ready. Okay. Now what other configurations and file you need? So here we are writing our code in src folder. Okay, I need to rename this. In the src we will be creating all the other files like app folder, services, configs, lib, all these will go inside this lib. Okay, other than that we have routes, controller, okay, you can have services. All these folders will go inside it. Okay. Now what we will have is we will have our Docker files and all also. So in src we will have app.ts TypeScript file. There you will write code to start up your server. Before that we will also have the other files because we will be using nodemon to run the application. Okay. So what we will do is we will add nodemon.js. So nodemon will use this TS node because we are going to write TypeScript code. So it will use TS node to run the code. So we don't need to just build this. We can run this on the fly with the help of nodemon. Nodemon will look for src-index.ts. So we'll have src-index.ts as a root file. Index.ts. And this is our nodemon in package.json. So you just hit npm run, simple nodemon. Nodemon will look into nodemon.json and it will execute this file. It will ignore all these. It will look for the extension ts in the src and it will also keep watching. Hot reloading will keep happen. The restart will keep happen. Now it is microservice and we are using Docker Compose. So we will also have a Docker file. In Docker file, we will write basic instructions. Okay, the basic instruction contains choosing a particular base image of Node.js, setting up working directory, copying the code, and doing the npm install. Right, copying all the code, then doing the npm install. There may be other steps also. Here we are not doing that. Otherwise, you will first copy the package.json, then do the npm install. Then copy the rest of the code, okay? So, but it's just an example. I'm exposing these two ports and finally I'm running npm run debug. So debug should be a command in my package.json to start my application. So if you just see, it can be a simple debug command. What debug command will be doing is, it will be just starting our application. Okay, so we will add a debug in our package.json. In the script tag, debug is just executing nodemon and passing the file. Even node mode is fine because node mode will look into node mode.json and will execute it. Okay. Apart from this Docker file and all, you will have ORM related configurations, tslint, tsconfig.json, because we are writing TypeScript file. We are writing TypeScript code. So tsconfig. So we are writing tsconfig.json. It is a compiler configuration, like what is our target, what is the source, what common modules we are using, what is the output directory, what all files, what we are excluding from the compilation. Okay, and tslint.json for linting. In the tslint, we will provide all the linting configurations. So it can be, I just copied it from the documentation. It will be all the configurations which we need for the tslint. Okay, apart from this, there will be a database level configurations, orm config.ts, because here we are using type orm. So we have to create orm config.ts, and it will populate it with the basic details like what is the migration directory, subscription directory, what is the CLI configurations like entities, migrations and subscriber directory, and all the MySQL related information, where are the entities, what is the username, password, database name, because we are using MySQL in this template. Okay, you can have an env file where you will populate all the information about your environment. Okay, so env file, because we are using .env, and here you will populate all the information. So once you fill it and start the server using .env module, we will be able to populate this db user password in the process.env folder, process.env object. Okay, now we can write our application. Okay, so here we have index.ts. Now index.ts will have our basic set of code, like we have a database service, we are starting a server. If I just put it from my sample code, we will get a database service. Here we will have a logger. Here we are starting the server, simple HTTP server, right? We are passing the express app instance, listening to this port, and once we started listening, we are waiting for database connections to get initialized. We are using MySQL, so we will keep waiting until our database connection established, and then our server will get started. Okay, so await database service.get connection. It will not hold your server to get started, but it will just start a database connection chain. So we will keep polling database again and again for the connection. Once the connection is successful, we will be able to see the message on the logs. Otherwise, the server is not stopping. We are not holding on to server before database connection gets received. It is just a check we have added. We just started polling database for connection, and then we are starting the server. Okay, so here you can see we are requiring .env config, which will populate everything from .env file to our process.env. And now rest all things, like you will be writing the routes, controllers, services, routes, migrations, because we will be using the different folders here. In the SRC, there can be middlewares. Okay, here we have a services, controllers, scripts, migration, database migrations we can have. Okay, migration, routes, lib, config, if config level data you can put. Okay, the internal config, and you will have a lib in which you can put a library like a logger, custom library, or you are connecting to the Redis. So Redis connection, middleware, like you are doing a custom error handling for all these internal server error record, bad request, all these kind of, this is the logger middleware, right? Middleware which will intercept these set of error codes and will send appropriate message to the client. Routes is simple as, if I just talk about simple routes, index.ts, we can use express router, right? Here user, for API v1 user, we will be talking to the user routes, and we will be importing it from here. In the users, you have defined all the routes. So in the index.ts, if I just talk about users.ts, Here I have defined this controller, okay, app controller, user controller. So from routes, we'll be talking to the controller. Controller will be talking to the services. Services will talk to the ORM layer, like we are using here type ORM. So type ORM repositories we will use to fetch the data, and the same data will be available in the controllers. So if we just talk about simple code, how our controller look like, then I will just try to just paste the code. I will not be writing it because we are just, I'm just showing what all things you should take care. Controller.ts, and here we have user controller. So all these methods, here you can see the proper try catch. Here we are getting the request response and next function. If the data is received, send the response back, otherwise send it to the next middleware. So this next middleware means these all the requests which are throwing server exceptions, internal server exceptions, bad request exceptions, those all will go to the error middleware. So in the middleware, we will create our middleware which will take care of our all error handling. So here we will create a error handler.ts. Okay, and this will take care of our error handling on a particular request. Okay, so like whatever the error from controllers we are getting from the routes, if we are getting like not found exception, then we will put a, we will just wrap the particular proper message and we will send the response back to the client. Okay, that is how our migrations are DB migrations. It can be SQLized migration, type ORM migration, because it depends on what type of ORM we are using. So the routes and all, and our app.ts, which will just take care of, if I just talk about our app.ts. So here is my app.ts. I will be importing all the body parser, cookie parser, express, creating the express instance, and then registering all the middlewares like security middlewares and all. And finally, I will be doing error handling. Okay, so here we are doing error handling, and here we are registering all the middlewares, right? Express set of all express middlewares like body parser, cookie parser and all. This is the middleware for error handling. We have a logger. So all these things are some kind of a common to create your base template. Okay, so here it is same as the MVC structure of express template. Here we just wrote some TypeScript files and we try to create a simple layer where routes to controller, controller to services, services will talk to our database layer. Okay, database can be MongoDB, MySQL or any other database. There are respective libraries are available to talk to that. Okay, now we have a Docker file, all the proper instructions, nodemon, how we need to run it. We can actually build it, the build the code using npm run build, and we can start it. So if we just go to package.json, how it will work is npm run build will use the TypeScript transpiler because we have tsconfig. So it will look into the source files and it will start compiling it and will create a dist folder. And start will just run the node index.js, because after .ts is getting compiled into .js and we are running it. Okay, so I will provide you the source code of this baseline template of Nest.js application, and from there Nest.js and Express both. So from there you can choose which template you wanted to use and start your microservices. You can connect to MySQL, Mongo, RabbitMQ, SQS, SNS, any different services or any particular microservice also. There can be a microservice to microservice communication happening in the request and reply fashion, which is synchronous, or fire and forget, which is asynchronous using proper messaging channels. Okay, like AMQP protocol, where you are sending a message to the SQS RabbitMQ and there are subscribers which are listening to that queue and will receive the event and will execute something. Okay, thanks everyone.